everyone and welcome back to my YouTube channel Physios Healing Touch. So I hope your day was phenomenal and today I will be talking about tests that are used to diagnose any rotator cuff muscle injury. So basically there are four muscles of rotator cuff which are supraspinatus, infraspinatus, teres minor and subscapularis. One important thing to note while diagnosing any shoulder injury is you cannot diagnose any shoulder injury just by doing test. You also need proper examination, observation, palpation of that area before coming to any conclusion. And sometimes you also need MRIs. So you cannot just diagnose just by doing test. You also need to examine that part thoroughly. So first I will tell you test for supraspinatus, because supraspinatus is one of the commonly injured muscle. So first test is drop arm test, and it is used to diagnose full thickness rotator cuff tear, particularly of supraspinatus. And according to an article done by Miller et al. In 2008, the sensitivity of this test is 73% and specificity is 77%. And it has moderate clinical value.
The therapist will abduct the patient's shoulder to about 90 degrees and then ask the patient to slowly lower the arm to the side. The test is negative if patient can slowly bring the arm to the side. This test will be positive if patient is unable to return the arm slowly to the side. This indicates rotator cuff tear.
Now next test is anti-can test or jog test, and the sensitivity of this test is 88% and specificity is 62%. Suppose this hand is affected and this is normal, but I will check both these hands just for comparison of the results.
So I will abduct the patient's shoulder to about 90 degrees and then I will horizontal adduct to about 30 degrees and then medially rotate so that the thumb point towards the floor, and then I will apply a downward resistance and ask the patient to hold this position. In a positive test, patient will unable to hold this position.
Next test is full can test. And according to a research done by Jen et al. In 2017, the sensitivity of this test is 70% and specificity is 81%. And it has moderate clinical value. According to EMG studies, both full can test and empty can test activate supraspinatus to about 90%. But there is also one more study in which EMG studies says it does not selectively activate supraspinatus, but these tests also activated 9 other muscles of shoulder up to that same level. So it does not selectively activate supraspinatus. So we cannot rely completely on these tests.
Now again bring the patient's both shoulder up to 90 degree abduction and then horizontally adduct to 30 degrees and then laterally rotate so that the thumb point towards the ceiling, and then apply a downward pressure and patient will hold that position. In case of positive test, patient will unable to hold that this position and there will be pain.
Now I will tell you test for subscapularis. First is belly press test. So the sensitivity of this test is 45% and specificity is 92%, and its accuracy is 69%. I will link that article below in the description box from where I found all these values so that you can also check that article.
So in this, the examiner has placed his hand over the abdomen just below the xiphoid crisis so that he can also feel the pressure applied by the patient. Ask the patient to medially rotate his shoulder and apply pressure as hard as he can. In a positive test, patient will unable to maintain this pressure.
Now next test is bear hug test. The sensitivity of this test is 75, specificity is 56, and accuracy is 65%.
Place the patient's testing shoulder on the top of other shoulder and his fingers will be extended. elbow will be in front of the body, and then support at the elbow, and then apply a laterally directed force and ask the patient to maintain this position. In a positive test, patient will unable to maintain this position.
Now next test for subscapularis is lift off test. The sensitivity of this test is 25% and specificity is 92%. Accuracy of this test is 59%.
Ask the patient to put his dorsum of the hand over the mid lumbar spine, and then ask the patient to lift his hand away from the back. If patient cannot do so, it indicates lesion in the subscapularis muscle. But if patient can able to lift, then apply a inward force towards the back and patient has to hold that position. In torn subscapularis, patient will unable to hold this position.
Now next, I will tell you test for infraspinatus. So first is lateral rotation lag sign, also known as infraspinatus spring back sign. This test is used to diagnose both for infraspinatus tears and teres minor tears. So for full thickness infraspinatus tear, the sensitivity of this test is 93% and specificity is 97%. Diagnose tear in teres minor, the sensitivity is 100% and specificity is 93%. So it has good accuracy to diagnose both infraspinatus and teres minor tears.
For this, flex the patient's elbow to about 90 degrees and then elevate the patient's shoulder in scapular plane for about 20 degrees and then externally rotate the shoulder to maximum, and then patient will hold this position. But in case of tear, patient will unable to hold this position and it will spring back anteriorly.
Next test for infraspinatus tears is infraspinatus test, and the sensitivity of this test is 90% and specificity is 74%, and it has moderate clinical value.
For this, bring the patient's elbow to about 90 degree flexion and then apply a medially directed force, and the patient will resist this force. The inability to resist medial rotation indicate positive test for infraspinatus tear.
Now next test I will tell you for teres minor, which is Horn-Blower sign, also called as PAT test, and it is used to diagnose degeneration in teres minor.
Passively abduct the patient's shoulder to about 90 degrees abduction in scapular plane, and then passively flex the patient's elbow to about 90 degrees and then ask the patient to laterally rotate against the resistance. In the positive test, patient will unable to laterally rotate the arm, and this indicate tear of teres minor.
So I hope this video was useful for you all, and please give your love and support to this channel, and please share this video ahead to your friends. And so yeah, I will see you in my next video.